Marxism, though discredited as a viable economic system, still has great appeal and usefulness as a method for historical, cultural, and aesthetic analysis. Of course, the basic principle is the effect of class differences. While there is nothing new about class distinctions as a part of societal structure, since the Industrial Revolution, the dominant class has controlled all aspects of production, separating workers from the product of their labor for the first time in history. The Industrial Revolution took place in countries where there was coincidentally an increasing degree of democracy. And actually, the democratic system parallels the most basic principle of capitalist society, that the common person has only three choices: buy this one, buy another one, or don't buy. In other words, all parts of culture, art, entertainment, politics, education, lifestyle, etc., all have become commodities whose production we cannot control. We do have the freedom of choice in democratic capitalism, but not the power to create new choices. We have an illusion of freedom, while actually the range of our freedoms is strictly limited by the dominant power block. The range of discourse is also defined for us, and the dominant power block, through its control of education, government, and media, limits this range by its ability to define what is normal, or common sense. The name of the ideology of the dominant power block is common sense. The real location of class struggle in our time is over the definition of our own lives. It is a semiotic struggle for the meaning of daily life. When you are born, you are told what your life will be. If you choose to buy another kind of life, that is your choice. But not buying that definition is a revolutionary act.
Thank you.